guys, welcome back. And today I'm going to show you what I bought while I was traveling. And no, I didn't buy makeup. I was good. I was really good. I have everything in this little Bath & Body Works bag. And I'm going to show you what it is if I can manage to open it up. There you go. So, first things first, I went to Bath & Body Works for just one thing, and those are wallflower plugs, because the ones that I get from the States are 110 volts, and the voltage here in Vietnam is 220, so I always end up with a power surge, and then the fuse blows, and I can't use the shit anymore. So I ended up buying two of these, and these were 360 baht, which is a little over $10. I think that's a little steep, honestly, but I wanted them. And then I went to Sephora. And what did I get in Sephora? I got the Sephora Express Nail Polish Remover. I tried it already. I still prefer the Bourjois, honestly. Then I also got the Sephora Gel Effect Top Coat. This one. And I don't like this. I still love my Revlon, I think it's called Diamond Top Coat, that turns also any polish into a gel look. This one, I'm really upset with this because I put on nail polish yesterday, and as you can probably tell, I don't have nail polish anymore, because other than making your nails look shiny, it doesn't do anything else. It doesn't help your nail polish stay on long, because mine chipped. And didn't just chip, it flaked this morning. And I was like, what? One day. My Revlon one helps my nail polish stay in for a week. This one day. What? So that was a waste of money. Don't buy that. And then, at Boots, yes, there's Boots in Thailand, I did get the Palmer's Cocoa Butter Formula Massage Cream for stretch marks. Okay, and I mentioned this already in my Get Ready With Me, or my Friday FOTD. I use this as a primer. I don't use this on my body. I use it as a primer for my face. It's got shea butter, argan oil, almond oil, collagen, and elastin. And the third ingredient on this is glycerin, which is a humectant. That means that it absorbs the moisture, and it also helps your makeup stay on your face, which is why the Nivea post-shave balm works really well, because of its glycerin content. So when I saw this, I got it, but it wasn't my idea. I saw it on Iris Balin. I'm going to link her channel down below and somewhere here, where she tests this against the Nivea Shave Balm. I can't find Nivea anywhere, so I got this instead, and it works pretty well. It's what's under my face right now, and it's very moisturizing as well, so kind of like it. No, I don't just kind of like it. I really like it. But we'll see until the rest of the month, and I'm definitely going to be doing a review of that. If you want to see that, do give me a thumbs up. And the last thing that I bought there is the Thursday Plantation Australia's Original Tea Tree Oil. This is 10 mil pure tea tree oil, because I had a huge zit on the side of my nose. And if you have runny nose, like I do now, and you have a huge zit on the side of your nose, you know how painful that can get when you try to blow your nose, right? So I got this, and in 2 days, zit was gone, completely dry. What else is in here? Oh, and in duty free, I did get the Hello Kitty by OPI nail varnish collection. So there's six of them there, and I used this color already, Dreams of Spring, and I really like that color. But because of the top coat, well, it didn't really stay on, it was overnight thing, and that was it. So I was really upset with that. That's all that I got, aside from like t-shirts, like souvenir t-shirts from the places that I went to. That's all that I got. I've been good. I went to two Sephoras, but I didn't end up buying anything. Great. Anyway, that's all that I have for you today. I'll see you all again in my next video. Subscribe if you haven't already and comment down below. If you're going to do the Sephora VIB sale, what are your must-buys?